Soon to Nine Peaks, so it's just awesome.
Just want to show you it outside. It's a little bit noisy here, but just look at it shine.
So, silent inside. If you compare it with the Garmin Mark, this is the Adventure from Garmin, which also looks very nice, but it's really, really expensive. It's over 1,000 bucks, so it's not really not a competitor. The real competitor, of course, of the Suunto 9 Peak is the Garmin Fenix 6. But just want to show you it next to some other watches. This is the Garmin 55, which is also kind of new. Yeah, it's really new. This is the Venue 2. This is the S version. But just let's take it for a closer look. What it does have, that's I think good to know. It has, of course, internally GPS. It has the optical heart rate on the back here, but it also measures SpO2. And before we go on, please, if you like it, please hit the thumbs up button. That would really help the channel. So thanks for that. I was talking about the shininess. It's more like a polished. It really looks high-end in my opinion, but you have to look like the very, it's like a Scandinavian design in my opinion, that's perhaps I would describe it, and you have to like it. Kind of big buttons here, there, those three. Of course this is changeable. I think they have also all kind of colors, but also leather straps, so more for like the daily use. But also this strap feels very nice. I do not really like this thing. This is like the flashy thing, but for me this always works the best, the old-fashioned one, but that's just really personal. Let's just continue, but before I do that, so some new features. So it has the new exterior design. If you compare it with the old Suunto 9, it has a Live Q, which is also in the Suunto 7 optical heart rate sensor, which is it is accurate. It's of course not the most accurate. That will be like the old-fashioned measuring device which you put on your finger or something, but the watch is also always a little bit not so precise. Also, if you do like a chest belt on, it's not as precise as like medical device. Just want to clear that out. It has fast charging. It has a better GPS route navigation, which they call snap to route. It has the tour mode. It has yeah, kind of a new light, ambient light. You can use it with the new Suunto app, of course. And it has the ghost runner screen option, and of course what I like is the SpO2 measurement unit on the back. Now I did not read the book. The book is still here inside the box of this 9 Peak. You get it in like a nice box. I bought it at Suunto and they just delivered it, so let's just see how this works. Can we make this a little bit lighter? Perhaps like this. You hear the clicking sounds of the buttons. Yeah, welcome. There we go. Let's search this. Metric, 24 hours. The weight, put in the weight. There we go. You heard a clicking noise. I don't know if you can put it off, but we'll search for that later. I don't really like the clicking sound, but yeah, it's kind of okay. This is really not what I'm used to, so perhaps that's the thing. Connect with mobile, no, I don't want to do that. No, I don't want to do that. Is that possible? Later, yeah. It's highly recommended. Okay, later. There we go. Time. Search for GPS. We are inside here. So when it searches, we just want to look at it. It has like here a little bit of this curvy line there. And this is, I think, the barometer, those small holes. Yeah, it looks so robust. I think that's the word. So, there we are. Time. But let's see. There we go. I think it should have found it, but the watch basics. Okay, start. Can we? Yeah. Oh, let's just show you. Good in the camera. Start an exit, view your log and just. Yeah. There we are. Daily the steps. Tap to toggle view. Just gonna clean it in one moment. So the screen is nice, but it gets dirty a little bit soon. Yeah, the touch is do I like that? Oh, key pressed. Okay, yeah, there we are. Alarms. Oh, swipe right. There we are. Yeah, all done. There we are. So, let's just show you everything and heart rate. Okay, let's just go measure. Go measure, go measure. Can I measure it with my thumb on the back? That also works on the garments and polars. Are we now measuring? I think so, we are measuring. Yeah, there we are. We can see it here. So, compare it to the Garmin. They are a lot smaller. That doesn't have anything to do with accuracy in my opinion, but we have to just check it. I will go running and cycling and swimming with it. Daily heart rate. Stress. Training. Altitude here. I think that's correct. Sleep tracking. Fitness level instructions. There we are. Can I just also do this or something? Navigation, log, timer, settings, let's just push this. That's the, yeah. Okay. Watch face. Okay. What do we have? General. Backlight. Give me some highlights. Yeah, I think that's better for the video. So brightness high. Back. Oh, that works kind of nice. So let's just scroll through all the settings, and I will of course make like videos about all the settings. Just toggle along, airplane mode, paired devices, discovery mode, outdoor, what is this, altitude, yeah, okay, go back, navigation, you have to calibrate it, so it has GPS and GLONASS and something I don't know, QZSS, never heard of that. Activity. Oh, I think I put. So you have to be a little bit precise on the how you tap this, or was that amount? That's the same thing. It looks the same. So training, sleep, and the watch face. So let's go back. So this is the home screen, and then we go to heart rate, it was measuring 83. The steps, that's really interesting because I didn't do any step. Yeah, perhaps a couple, but not 124. But like every watch, when you buy it, it has just to, yeah. It has to be like, it has to get used to how you function, your heart rate, etc. In my opinion, they always get more accurate when you use it longer. So that's, I think it's good to say. But now, I just want to go running. How do I do that? Is that just play this? Nope, this one, yeah, exercise. Can I just... I want to go running. This and then this one. Then I want to swipe another exercise. Just tap it perhaps. Ah, that's just running. Set up your wrist exercise. Before starting, wait, yeah. I'm not really a waiting guy, so I just want to go. I just want to go running. So I test my heart rate for the first time. So we have to just wait for the GPS. Still, we are still inside, so I don't know if it will get the GPS. But I think that's good for the video, just to see how it works. And in the meantime, just show you again the heart rate. Colory LED lights on the back. So it is the peak version. It doesn't say here like peak, but it is the peak version. I paid like 450 with it. I bought it at Suunto. We still don't have a GPS, so I put this. The quit guide, so that's nice. Go back. Can we go back like this? Yep. Okay. Now I want to do another exercise. Another thing. Ah, there we are. Cycling, hiking, trail running, pool swimming. I will do something with that. Weight training, the treadmill, indoor cycle, open water swimming. Yeah. I will be doing that in a short while because it's nice swimming weather. Mountaineering, that's a cool word. Mountaineering, cool. Yoga and Pilates, other, I think it's enough. Let's go do some open water swimming. There we go. Also, again, looking for GPS. What I will do, I will be going now swimming and doing also cycling perhaps tonight. And who knows what becomes after that. So that's the Suunto 9 Peak. I do think you have like an understanding about it. It's just how I got it in the box, now totally set up. So ready for running, next to the Garmin. How big is it? It's way smaller. This is the Garmin 55, which is a small watch. And the Suunto is a little bit bigger, but not that much. A little bit bigger. So, that's it. Please subscribe to the channel if you will want to see all the videos about the Suunto 9 Peak. And I'm going swimming now. So, thanks and bye.